Hello friends, now we'll start the new chapter, chapter number 5, sets and relation. Now in this video, I will explain first the basic concept, all these odd examples, and in next video, I will explain the exercise 5.1. Okay. You will get the link of my next video if we click the I button. Okay. विद्यार्थी मित्रों अपन पाचवे प्रकरण आता सुरू करणार आहोत आणि या व्हिडिओ मध्ये मी सेट्स या संबंधीचे बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट आणि एक्सरसाइज 5.1 च्या आधीची सर्व सॉल्ड एग्जांपल्स अतिशय सोप्या भाषेत सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न करणार आहे. ओके, नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट. लेट्स स्टडी रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल लर्न व्हाट यू विल लर्न रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ अ सेट इंटरवल्स टाइप्स ऑफ सेट ऑपरेशन्स ऑन सेट्स order pair relations. Now in your previous standard you have learned, that is in 9th standard, you have learned all these types of the concept, that is the representation of set in, okay, and the types of sets and operations on the sets. Yapuricha yattan madhe tumhi representation of sets bagitle, types of set bagitle, and some operations te bagitle. Okay, now let's recall the concept of a set was developed by German mathematician George Cantor. You have already learned about sets and some basic operations involving them in earlier standards. Okay. In everyday life, we generally talk about group or a collection of objects. Surely, you must have used the word such as, okay. Such as team, bouquet, bunch, flock, family for collection of family for the collection of different objects. It's very important to determine whether a given object belongs to a given collection or not. Okay. Consider the following collections. Successful persons in your city, happy people in your town, clever student in your class, days in a week, first five natural numbers. First three collections are not examples of sets, but last two collections represent sets. Okay. This is because in first three collections, we are not sure of the objects. What is that? The terms successful persons. ओके फर्स्ट काय तर सक्सेसफुल पर्सन या बाबतीत हे कलेक्शन हे काही सेट होऊ शकणार नाही. हॅपी पीपल क्लेवर स्टुडंट्स आर ऑल रिलेटिव टर्म्स. हियर द ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर नॉट वेल डिफाइंड. ओके इन द लास्ट टू कलेक्शन्स वी कॅन डिटरमाइन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स क्लिअरली. दस वी कॅन से दॅट्स ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर वेल डिफाइंड. ओके इन द लास्ट टू this is the objects are well defined, but the happy people, clever student, we cannot determine the perfectly. What about the clever student? Which are the happy people, the persons who are the successful? We cannot define this. It is a different for the different terms. It is a relative terms. Okay, now the definition of the set. Definition: a collection of well defined objects is called a set. Objects in a set is called its elements or member. We denote sets by capital letters A, B, C, etc. The elements of a set are represented by small letters A, B, C, X, Y, Z, etc. If X is an element of a set capital A, we write small x belongs to capital A and read as X belongs to A. If X is not an element of capital A, we write X does not belongs to A and read as X does not belongs to A. For example, 0 is a whole number but not a natural number. See this here, 0 belongs to W. Okay, and 0 does not belongs to set of natural number. Now the next representation, how to represent a set. There are two methods of representing a set. Set representation cha don methods you are learning in your previous standard. That is in navit tumhi he shiklela. Roster or the tabular method or list method. Okay. Next, set builder or the rule method, and the third is a Venn diagram. Now see this here. The roster or the tabular method or the list method. In the roster method, we list all the elements of the sets within brackets and separate the elements by the commas. Okay. Examples, the state, the set using the roster method. First, B is the set of all days in a week. That is B is equals to in curly bracket Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. C is the set of all vowels in English alphabets. That is C is equals to in curly bracket A, E, I, O, U, like this. Okay. Now the set builder method. In the set builder method, we describe the elements of the set by specifying the property which determines the elements of the set uniquely. त्यामध्ये एक प्रॉपर्टी आपण करत असतो आणि पर्टिक्युलरली तोच एलिमेंट युनिक एलिमेंट त्या सेटमध्ये तिथे आला पाहिजे. एक्झाम्पल्स, स्टेट द सेट युझिंग सेट बिल्डर मेथड. नाव द फर्स्ट एक्झाम्पल, वाय इज द सेट ऑफ ऑल मंथ्स ऑफ अ इयर. ओके, देन वाय इज इक्वल्स टू इन कर्ली ब्रॅकेट एक्स इज सच दॅट एक्स इज मंथ ऑफ इयर. ओके. नेक्स्ट, बी इज द सेट ऑफ परफेक्ट स्क्वेअर्स ऑफ नॅचरल नंबर्स. ओके, B is equals to in curly bracket x belongs to capital N and x is a perfect square, and this is the set builder method. Which are the rules here? X is the month of a year. What is next? X is perfect square. These are the rules. Now the next method to represent a set, which is the Venn diagram. The pictorial representation of a set is called Venn diagram. Generally, the geometrical closed figures like circle, triangle or rectangle are used to represent the sets, which are known as Venn diagram and are named after the English logician John Venn. Okay. In Venn diagram, the elements of the sets are shown as a point enclosed in the diagram representing set. Now see this here, A is equals to in curly bracket 1, 2, 3. Yeah, prakare. B is equals to, this is the first set. It is shown in this diagram. That is a circular diagram, oval shape. B is equals to, it's a square shape. A, B, C, D, E, F. It's represented like this. C is equals to the triangle shape. 4, 5, 6. These are the 4, 5, 6. These are the Venn diagram. Now the next, what is note, important note, if the elements are repeated, write them once. जर एखाद्या सेटमध्ये जर दोन पेक्षा जास्त वेळा असेल तर तो एकदाच तो एलिमेंट इथे येणार आहोत आपण. While listing the elements of a set, the order in which the elements are listed is immaterial. ऑर्डर कुठल्याही ऑर्डर मध्ये तुम्ही ते एलिमेंट्स लिहिले तरी चालू शकतात. ओके, दिस इज द इम्पॉर्टंट नोट. नाव द नेक्स्ट, नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ अ सेट, इट इज कॉल्ड द कार्डिनॅलिटी. द नंबर ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट एलिमेंट कंटेंट इन अ फायनाइट सेट कॅपिटल ए इज डिनोटेड बाय एन ऑफ ए. दस इफ कॅपिटल ए इज इक्वल्स टू 1, 2, 3, 4, देन द एन ऑफ ए इज इक्वल्स टू 4. ओके, नाव द टाइप्स ऑफ sets. First is empty set. A set containing no element is called an empty or null set and is denoted by the symbol phi or this type of the empty curly bracket, or it is a white set. For example, it is an interesting example. A is equals to in curly bracket x is such that x belongs to set of natural number and x lies between 1 and 2. Is there any natural number between 1 and 2? No. Therefore, there is no element and hence it is an empty set. Number of the elements, n of a is equals to 0. Okay, this is the definition of the empty set and their example. Now the next, singleton set. A set containing only one element is called a singleton set. For example, let capital A be the set of all integers which are neither positive nor negative. Okay. या टाइपचा सेट्स पाहिजे की आपल्याला तो पॉझिटिव्ह पण नको पाहिजे आणि निगेटिव्ह पण नको पाहिजे. दिस टाइप ऑफ सेट दॅट इज अ इंटीजर. देन दी नायदर पॉझिटिव्ह नॉर निगेटिव्ह. देअरफॉर कॅपिटल ए इज इक्वल्स टू इन कर्ली ब्रॅकेट ओनली द झिरो इज द एलिमेंट विच इज नायदर पॉझिटिव्ह नॉर निगेटिव्ह. ओके, तोच एक आहे. देअरफॉर एन ऑफ ए इज इक्वल्स टू वन अँड दिस इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ द सेट ऑफ सिंगलटन सेट. नेक्स्ट, finite set. A set in which the process of counting of elements comes to an end is called a finite set. For example, the set of letters in the word beautiful. Okay, and it is a capital A is equals to in curly bracket B E A U T I F U, this is the L. Okay, then the number of elements are n of A is equals to 8. A is a finite set in this way. Next, infinite set. A set which is not finite is called an infinite set. For example, set of natural numbers. Now the next, fifth definition. A set A is said to be a subset of set B if every element of A is also an element of B, and we write A is a subset of B. Note first that the phi is a subset of every set. Empty set is a subset of every set. Next, second, A is a subset of A, that is every set is a subset of itself in this way. Now the next, superset. If A is a subset of B, then B is called the superset of A, and we write B is a superset of A. Next, the proper set. A non-empty set A is a set to be a proper subset of the set B if all elements of A are in set B and at least one element of B is not in A, that is, if A is a subset of B and A is not equals to B, then A is called the proper subset of B and we write A is a subset of B. म्हणजे बी मध्ये एक तरी इलेमेंट ए पेक्षा कसा असला पाहिजे, तर जास्त असला पाहिजे, देन इट इज कॉल्ड द प्रॉपर सबसेट. ओके, लेट ए इज इक्वल्स टू इन कर्ली ब्रॅकेट 135 अँड बी इज इक्वल्स टू 1357, देन एव्हरी इलेमेंट ऑफ ए इज अँड इलेमेंट ऑफ बी बट ए इज नॉट इक्वल्स टू बी अँड देअरफॉर ए इज अ सबसेट ऑफ बी, दॅट इज ए इज अ प्रॉपर सबसेट ऑफ बी. ओके, दिस इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ द प्रॉपर सेट अँड एक्झाम्पल. Now the remark, if there exists even a single element in A which is not in B, then A is not a subset of B and we write A is a not subset of B. Okay. Now the next definition, power set. The set of all subsets of a given set A is called the power set of A and is denoted by P of A. Thus, every element of power set A is a set. For example, consider the set capital A in curly bracket AB. Let us write all the subsets of the set A. We know that the phi is a subset of every set. So, phi is a subset of A. Now, see this here. The subsets, other subsets, the singleton element A, B, AB are also subsets of A. Thus, the set A has in all four subsets. The first is phi A B A B and hence the power set P of A is equals to phi A B A B in this way. Okay, now this is the definition of the power set and the examples. Now we'll see the next, equal sets. Manje kay equal sets? Two sets are said to be equal if they contain the same elements. Okay, if A is a subset of B and B is also subset of A, then the two sets are said to be equal. Okay, for example, if X is the set of letters in the word ABBA and Y is a set of letters in the word BABA. Okay, Then what are the elements of X? The elements of the X are AB. And what about the element of Y? The elements of Y are BA. Okay. Now the next. Thus the sets X and Y are equal sets, and we denote it by X is equals to Y. Okay. Now the next definition. Two finite sets A and B are said to be equivalent if N of A is equals to N of B. Okay. Now see this, the A in curly bracket DOME. Okay. And the B is another set R A C K. These are the elements of the sets. Here the N of A is equals to N of B. That is the number of the elements in A is 4. Number of the elements in B is also 4. N of A is equals to N of B, and hence therefore A and B are the equivalent sets. म्हणजे त्यातले elements different असले तर चालतील, परंतु number of the elements कसे असले पाहिजे, तर same असले पाहिजे. Then we say that the two sets are the equivalent set. Now the universal set. This is very important. If in a particular discussion all the sets under consideration are the subsets of a set, say U, okay, then U is called the universal set for that discussion. If we are considering the sets of books in the library, that is the books are important in this section in your library, that is also important. Therefore in a particular discussion all the sets under the consideration are the subset of a set, say U, then the U is called the universal set for that discussion. The set of natural numbers, capital N, the set of integers, Z, are the subsets of the set of real number. Okay. If you consider the set of real number, this is the universal. And then what about set of natural number is a subset of real number. Set of integer is also a set of a real number. Okay. Thus, for this discussion, what is this? In this discussion, R is the universal set. Okay. In general, universal set is denoted by capital U or the capital X. Okay. Now the operations on the sets. First is complement of a set. First is a complement of a set. Let A be a subset of universal set. The complement of the set A is denoted by A dash or A raised to this small c. Okay. It is defined as A complement is equals to in curly bracket X is such that X belongs to universal but X does not belongs to capital A. Okay. And the set of all elements in U which are not in A, then it is called the A complement. Okay. Let X is equals to in curly bracket 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 be the universal set, and A is equals to 2, 4, 6, 8. Then what about its a complement? See this here, the Venn diagram. X is the universal set. Okay. And A contains 2, 4, 6, 8. And what about its a complement? Its a complement is a other than 2, 4, 6, 8, which are in X, which are the 0, 1, 3, 5 and the 7. This is the A complement. Okay. Therefore, the complement of the set A is A dash and the elements are 0, 1, 3, 5, 7, which are not in A, but they are in U. Okay. Now the properties. Complement of complement is the original set. Okay. 5 dash. That is a set of empty set. That's as a complement. Then you will get the U, where the U is a universal set for that particular discussion. Okay, phi dash U dash is equals to phi. If A is a subset of B, then complement of B dash is also subset of complement of A dash. Next, the union of sets. Union of sets A and B is the set of all elements which are in A or in B. Here the or is taken in the inclusive sense. For thus, A union B is equals to X is such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. The union of the two sets A and B can be represented by a Venn diagram. Okay, figure. Now see this, the figure A union B. This is U is the universal set and this is the A and B. It's also A union B. If the sets are like this, if they have the common element, then you can represent the A union B like this. Okay. Now the properties of the union. Okay. A union B is equals to B union A. It's a commutativity. Then A union B, त्यामध्ये जर सी टाकला इट्स डजंट इम्पॅक्ट ए युनियन बी ब्रॅकेट कम्प्लीट युनियन सी इज इक्वल्स टू ए युनियन इन ब्रॅकेट बी युनियन सी अँड इट इज अ असोसिएटिव्ह प्रॉपर्टी ए युनियन फाय इज इक्वल्स टू ए आयडेंटिटी ऑफ द युनियन ए युनियन ए दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू ए अँड दिस इज द आयडेम्पोटेंट लॉ ए युनियन ए कॉम्प्लिमेंट दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू यू इफ ए इज अ सबसेट ऑफ बी देन ए युनियन बी is equals to B. Jo biggest asel to. U union A that is equals to U. A is next. A is a subset of A union B and B is also subset of A union B. Okay, you can see this all the property. Now the one more example. Let A is equals to in curly bracket X is such that X is a prime number less than 10. B is equals to in curly bracket X is such that X is a factor of 8. Then find A union B. Now the first set A, the definition is that X is the prime number less than 10. Now the prime number, which are the prime number 2, 3, 5, 7, these are the prime number and therefore A is equals to 2, 3, 5, 7. What about the B? B is equals to in curly bracket X is such that X is a factor of 8, means the elements which divides the number 8. They are the 1, 2, 4 and 8. Therefore, B is equals to 1, 2, 4, 8. Okay. Now, their union. A union B is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Okay. This is the union. Now, the next. Intersection of sets. The intersection of two sets, A and B, is the set of all elements which are both in A and B. And it is denoted by A intersection B. Intersection मध्ये जे elements असतात ते दोन्ही sets मध्ये common elements आपण घेत असतो and therefore that elements contain in both the sets. Therefore A intersection B is equals to X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. This is the A intersection B. Okay. Okay. Now the next. The shaded portion in the figure represent the intersection of A and B. It is denoted A intersection B. Now the next the properties. A intersection B is equals to B intersection A. It is a commutativity. A intersection B intersection C is equals to A intersection in bracket B intersection C. Okay. Now the associative. Phi. Intersection A is phi. A intersection A is A. That is the idempotent law. A intersection A complement is equals to pi. If A is a subset of B, then A intersection B is A. Next property, U intersection A is equals to A. And the eighth one, A in bracket A intersection B is a subset of A. A intersection B is also subset of B. Now the important remark, if A intersection B is equals to pi, and A, then the what is happening? A and B are the disjoint set. If A is equals to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and B is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then find A intersection B, means the common element. Therefore, A intersection B is 1, 3, 5, 7 in this way. Now, the next example. If A is equals to in curly bracket, X is such that X is a factor of 12 and B is equals to in curly bracket, X is such that X is a factor of 18. Then find A intersection B. X is a factor of 12 means what? The numbers which divide the 12. That is A is equals to in curly bracket 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. And B is equals to the X is a factor of 18. Means what? The number which divides the 18. 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18. What about their intersection? A intersection B is equals to 1, 2, 3, 6 in this way. Next example, if A is equals to in curly bracket 13579 and B is equals to in curly bracket 246810, then find A intersection B. Is there any common element? No. Therefore, the A intersection B is empty, which is the 5. Now, the important law, De Morgan's law. If A and B are the subsets of a universal set, then in bracket A and B, complement is equals to A complement intersection B complement. Bracket asel, tyacha complement asel, taya union cha kay hoto, ta intersection. Okay. In bracket A, intersection B, it's a complement. Tyacha complement asel, ta intersection cha union aplyala milto. That's equals to A complement union B complement. Now the difference of sets. The difference of set A and the set B is the set of elements which are in A but not in B is denoted by A minus B. A minus B is the set of the elements which are in A but not in B. The shaded portion in figure represent A minus B. A minus B. Okay, see this here. A minus B. Here the elements are such that X is such that X belongs to A. But X does not belongs to B. फक्त आपण इथले elements consider करतो आणि जे common elements असतात A आणि B मधले ते A मधन काय करत असतो तर minus करत असतो. Similarly here B minus A. B minus A मध्ये फक्त या बाजूचेच elements आपल्याला इथे मिळणार. Okay. Okay. These are the B minus A, all these elements. Okay. And this is the okay. These are the only A minus B. And what about their common part? The common part is nothing but the A intersection B. Okay, it's a common part. Now the next one. Similarly, B minus A is such that Y is such that Y is in B but Y is not in A. Okay, yeah, prakare. Let's note A minus B is a subset of A and the B minus A is a subset of B. The set A minus B, A intersection B, B minus A are mutually disjoint set. These are all the difference. This is the first and this is the second and this is the third one. They are the different. They do not have any common element and that's why they are the mutually disjoint sets. For that is the their intersection. That is the intersection of any of these two sets is the null. That is an empty set. Next, this is also very important. A minus B, that's equals to A intersection B complement. And B minus A is equals to A complement intersection B. This is also important. Also, A union B is equals to, that is a minus B union, in bracket, A intersection B union, B minus A. Okay. And this is the, if you see this, 1, 2, 3, it is a union B. It is a union of A minus B, union with A intersection B, union with B minus A in this way. Okay. Now, A minus B, A intersection B and the B minus A. Now this, you can see this here. Again, one more concept. What is that? A minus B union B minus A. That is a delta B. It is called the symmetric difference of the set A and B. Here, the one more example. If A is equals to in curly bracket 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and B is equals to in curly bracket 3, 5, 6, 8, 9. Then, find A minus B. Okay, दोघांमध्ये common element कोणकोणते आहेत तर 4 नाहीये 5 is a common element. Okay, we'll delete the 5. Next 6 देखील common आहे 6 पण delete करणार आपण त्यातन. Okay, 7 7 is not the common element. 8 8 is the common element. 8 is the common element म्हणजे आपण कोणते element घेणार A मधले फक्त 4 and the 8 and this is the A minus B. The elements are 4 and 7. Next, B minus A. Okay. And for the B minus A, see this here. B minus A kartana. Okay. 3. Ite 3 gaisaga. Okay. We'll take the element 3. And what about the 5? 5 nahi hai na? Okay. Because the 5 is a common element. What about the 6? 6 pan nahi hai na? And next 8. 8 is also common. 9. 9 is not the common element. Therefore, the B minus A is 3, 9. Okay. Now next, asymmetric B, and that is equals to A minus B union B minus A. What about their union? That is a union of 4, 7, union 3, 9. And therefore, we get the elements 3, 4, 7, 9. This is the A delta B. Now the properties. A delta B is equals to in bracket A union B minus in bracket A intersection B. त्या दोघातले कॉमन एलिमेंट्स आपल्याला तिथे नको पाहिजे. ओके. A डेल्टा A इज इक्वल्स टू फाय. ओके. नेक्स्ट A डेल्टा फाय अँड दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू A. A डेल्टा B इज इक्वल्स टू A डेल्टा C. देन दी A सॉरी B इज इक्वल्स टू C. व्हाट अबाउट द नेक्स्ट A डेल्टा B इज इक्वल्स टू B डेल्टा A. A इंटरसेक्शन इन ब्रैकेट B डेल्टा C इज इक्वल्स टू in bracket A intersection B delta in bracket A intersection B. Okay, these are the properties of the symmetry. Now the next properties of cardinality of sets. For given sets A and B, n of A union B is equals to n of A plus n of B minus their intersection, that is n of A intersection B. When A and B are the disjoint set, that is that they do not have any common element, then A n of A union B is equals to n of A plus n of B, and A intersection B, that's equals to phi. Okay, therefore n of A intersection B is equals to 0. Okay. Now the next, n of A intersection B complement plus n of A intersection B, and that's equals to n of A. N of A complement intersection B plus n of A intersection B, and that is equals to B. These are the important formulas. N of A intersection B complement plus n of A intersection B plus n of A complement intersection B, and that is equals to n of A union B. Therefore, for the next, any sets ABC, this is also important formula. N of A union B union C is equals to n of A plus n of B plus n of C minus n of A intersection B minus n of B intersection C minus n of A intersection C plus n of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, this is also important when we consider about the three sets. Next, if n of A is equals to m, and then the power sets, how many power sets will be there? That is the n of powers, number of the power sets is equals to, that is equals to 2 raised to m, where P of A is the power set of A. Next, n of A delta B is equals to n of A plus n of B minus 2 times n of A intersection B. Okay, these are the important properties. Okay, now the important note. An empty set is a finite set. Nz sets of all the points on a circle are the infinite sets. Okay, n is also infinite set, z is also infinite set, and set of all the points on a circle are the infinite set. Now the next, the important, let's learn the intervals. The first is the open interval. When we say that the given interval is open, let A B belongs to set of real number and A is less than B, then the set X is such that X belongs to R and X lies between A and B is called open interval and is denoted by this type of the open interval AB. All the numbers between A and B belongs to the open interval AB, but not AB themselves do not belong to this interval. Okay. Open interval madhe kay ki A and B darmanche sagle points astat, A and B is not included in that interval. Okay. Now see this, if we represent on the number line, then the AB, here A and B are not included. Manun ha jo circle hai, to empty circle hai tha dhaakule. It is not the shaded. Okay. all the points between the A and B, but A and B are not included in this interval. Okay. Now the closed interval. Let A comma B belongs to set of real number A is less than B, then the set X is such that X belongs to R and X lies between A and B, equal to A and equal to B is also. It is called the closed interval and is denoted by closed interval AB. All the numbers between A and B belongs to the closed interval AB. Also A and B belongs to this interval. It is A and B interval. A and B kya open interval madhe navta, but in this case we are considering that A and B, these are also included in that interval, and then we say that it is a closed interval. See this here, the circle is a shaded here, darkly shaded. Here is a darkly shaded. Ite bakat open hota, therefore it is open interval. A and B are not included, here A and B is included, and that's why we write here closed is equals to closed interval AB is equals to X is such that X belongs to set of real number. X lies between A and B and equal to A also and equal to B also. X equals to A also and X equals to B also. Next, the semi-closed means what? One side is closed, another is a open. X is such that X belongs to set of real number and X lies between A and B and equal to X also, equal to A also. Means what here? We consider here is a shaded dark circle and here is a open circle. And this is also, we can represent on the number line. This is the semi-closed interval. Next, semi-open interval. Okay, that is a starting with the open and end with the closed. X is such that X belongs to R and X lies between A and B. Now here the A is a open and B is a closed. X lies between A and B. Okay. And in this case, the A excludes but B includes. Now the next. The set of all real numbers greater than A. Set of all real numbers greater than A. That is, X is greater than A. And it was a number line worthy of represent karaycha asel. Then how to represent? This starts from A up to the infinity. Okay. Set of real number greater than A, which is the open interval, starts from A and the ends with the infinity. X is such that X belongs to R. X is greater than A. X, A is not included here. Okay. Now the set of all real numbers greater than or equal to A. Okay. My real number greater than or equal to A. Closed interval A. Open interval infinity. X is such that X belongs to R and X is greater than or equals to A. This way. Okay. Manu iti ha shaded ghetela hai. Because it is a closed. A is a closed in this interval. Now the next. Set of all real numbers less than B, less than B, B peksha lahan asnare, means what? They are to the left hand side. Okay. Minus up the minus infinity to B. X is such that X belongs to R and X is less than B. Therefore, the set of all real numbers less than or equals to B is a minus infinity to here the minus infinity to B. B is a closed here and therefore the it is a shaded. Okay. And it is represented like this. Minus infinity to B. X is such that X belongs to R and X is less than or equals to B. Now the next is a set of real numbers and this is nothing but the total line starting with the origin. Minus infinity to plus infinity. And it is represented minus open interval minus infinity to plus infinity. X is such that X belongs to set of real number. X lies between minus infinity to plus infinity. Now we will see the solved examples. The first example, if A is equals to X is such that X is a factor of 6 and B is equals to X is such that X is a factor of 8. Find A minus B and B minus A. Okay. Now we'll see the first set A. A is equals to X is such that X is a factor of 6. Means what? The elements which divides the number 6. Kon kon divide karna? 1, 2, 3, 6. All these elements divide the 6. Therefore, the set A contains 1, 2, 3, 6. What about the B? B is equals to, in curly bracket, X is such that X is a factor of 8. That is the elements which divides the number 8. What are the elements? 1, 2, 4, 8. These numbers are ki te 8 la divide karta. Okay. Then what about the A minus B? A minus B. Manje common elements matna apan ya dogatna delete karna. Which are the common element? 1 gela ite 2. Okay. Next, there is no common element. Now, therefore the A minus B is 3 and 6. What about the B minus A? B minus A, 1, 2, these are the common element. What are the remaining element? 4 and 8. And hence, B minus A is 4 and 8. जो B मदना A चे minus करना, common elements कोना चे delete करना, दोगाद मदले पक्त 1 and 2, 4 and 8 है. Now the next example. A is equals to in curly bracket 1 upon x is such that x belongs to set of natural number and x is less than 8. Also B is equals to in curly bracket 1 upon 2x, x belongs to set of natural number and x is less than or equals to 8. Then find A minus B and B minus A. Okay. Now here A is equals to in curly bracket 1 upon x, x belongs to set of natural number and x is less than 8. Okay. मग A मध्ये कोणकोणते नंबर्स येतील. The first is 1 upon 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, 1 upon 5, 1 upon 6, 1 upon 7. Okay. These are the elements in set A. What about the next? B. B is equals to in curly bracket 1 upon 2x. Okay. Where the x belongs to set of natural number and x is less than or equals to 8. Okay. मग कोणकोणते if we take n is equals to 1, 2 into 1, that is 2. N is equals to 2, 2 into 2, 4. N is equals to 3, 2 into 3, 6. If you take 4, 8, 5, 10, 6, 12, 7, 14, and 8 means what? 16. In this way, B madhe kon kon the elements 1 upon 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 6, 1 by 8, 1 by 10, 1 by 12, 1 by 14, 1 by 16. In this way, these are the elements containing the set B. आता पुढे हे दोन्ही आपण सेट्स लेणार. नाउ फाइंड आउट ए माइनस बी. ओके, मग दोघातले कॉमन एलिमेंट्स ए आणि बी मध्ये कॉमन एलिमेंट कोणते? तर ते ए मधले आपण ते कट करणार. व्हिच आर द कॉमन एलिमेंट? हियर इज अ 1 अपॉन 2. 1 अपॉन 2 कट करणार यातला फर्स्ट एलिमेंट 1 आहे का? नाही. देन टेक द 1. नेक्स्ट 1 बाय 3 आहे का? 1 बाय 3 इज नॉट कॉमन एलिमेंट, देयरफॉर वी आर टेकिंग द हियर 1 बाय 3. नेक्स्ट 1 बाय 4. 1 बाय 4 इज अ कॉमन एलिमेंट, त्यामुळे तो आपण किती घेणार आहे. नेक्स्ट 1 बाय 5 इथे कॉमन नाहीये, देयरफॉर वी आर टेकिंग द 1 बाय 5. व्हाट अबाउट द 1 बाय 6? 1 बाय 6 कॉमन आहे, त्याला आपण काढणार. नेक्स्ट 1 बाय 7. 1 बाय 7 इज नॉट द कॉमन एलिमेंट अँड हियर वी आर टेकिंग द 1 बाय 7 अँड हेन्स ए मायनस बी ओके इज इक्वल्स टू 1, 1 बाय 3, 1 बाय 5, 1 बाय 7. दीज आर द ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ए. Which are the common element? 1 upon 2 common hata, 1 by 4 common hata, 1 by 6 common hata. Tyamule apan ya A minus B madhe te ghetle nahi. What about the B minus A? Ata B minus A karat astana ka ki 1 by 1 upon 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 6, these are the common element, te nahi ghenar. Next 1 by 8 aahe ka yachyamadhe? Nahi. Therefore we are taking the 1 by 8. 1 by 10, yes, we are taking 1 by 12. 1 by 10, 1 by 12, 1 by 14, 1 by 16. These are the different elements. They are not the common elements. And hence, B minus A is equals to 1 by 8, 1 by 10, 1 by 12, 1 by 14, 1 by 16. Okay. Now, the next example. If A is equals to in curly bracket 1, 2, 3, 4. B is equals to 3, 4, 5, 6. C is equals to 5, 6, 7, 8. D is equals to 7, 8, 9, 10. Then find A and B. A union B union C, B union C union D are the sets A, B, C, D equivalent. Okay. Now the solution. First, A union B. Okay. Ya doga madhle apan union tayar karna. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And D 5, 6. Which are the common? 3 and 4 is a common. A union B. Next, the A union B union C. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And included again one more, the 7 and 8 yamadi include karna, that then you will get the A union B union C is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What about the next? B union C union D. Okay. B union C, union D. Then again you will get here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and the last is a 9 and 10. And this is the B, union C, union D. Okay. As the number of elements in every set A, B, C, D is a 4. You can see this. Number of the elements 4, 4, 4, 4. Okay. The sets A, B, C, D are the equivalent sets, because the next question was, are the sets A, B, C, D equivalent? Yes. The number of elements are the same. Therefore, the set A, B, C, D are the equivalent. Next. Example number 4. Let U is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. B the universal set. A is a 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. B is a 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 10. C is a 6, 7, 8, 9. Then find A complement. Now A complement is equals to the number of elements which are in U but not in A. Now U is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And B is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Other than 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Which are the 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. Next, A intersection, C complement. Now see this here, A. Sorry. U first, then A. Then the C. Their intersection. What are the common elements? The common elements 7 and 9 only. 7 and 9. And their complement. Therefore, the A intersection C complement is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 10. These are the elements. Okay. Which are other than 7 and 9. Because we want to find out the A intersection C complement, which is the U. Okay. Other than 7 and 9. But 7 and 9 sodun sagle upon A intersection C madhe C cha complement. A complement and it's a complement. Now here U. What about the A? A is a 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. That's a complement. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. Again, that's a complement. That is nothing but the 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. And that is the original set. Okay. Now the next. B minus C. That's a complement. Okay. U, I, aplela. B, I, C, I. Now the B minus C. Now, 2 is a common. No, 2 is not common element. Therefore, we are taking the 2. 3. 3 is not common element. 4. 4 common aika. Okay. Next, 6. 6 is common. 2 naigana. 8 is common. Naigana. 10. 10 is not common element. Therefore, the B minus C is equals to 2, 3, 4, 10. What about their complement? B minus C complement is equals to, that is a, other than 2, 3, 4, 10, which are in U. Therefore, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the B minus C complement. Now the next question number 5. Let X be the universal set for the non-empty sets A and B. Verify the De Morgan's law. What is the first? A union B complement is equals to A complement intersection B complement. This is the first one. Second is A intersection B complement is equals to A complement union B complement. X is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and B is 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. Easy. Okay. If X apply I, AI, their union. Okay. Their union is A union B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is A union B. What about the A intersection B? Common elements upon Tatli. Common elements, that is a 1, 2, 5, these are the common elements. What about the complement? Complement, A complement is equals to other than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which are in X. That is a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. B complement, other than 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. What are this element? 3, 4, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Now the next, we'll prove the first law. A union B complement is equals to A complement intersection B complement. First, A union B complement, which is the 8, 9, 10. Okay. Now see this here. A union B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then other than these elements which are in X. ओके मग कोणकोणते एलिमेंट्स राहिले ए युनियन बी कॉम्प्लिमेंट मध्ये कोणते एलिमेंट्स येतील 8 9 10 ओके नेक्स्ट ए कॉम्प्लिमेंट इंटरसेक्शन बी कॉम्प्लिमेंट मीन्स व्हाट द कॉमन एलिमेंट व्हिच आर द कॉमन एलिमेंट 6 इज कॉमन नो 6 इज नॉट 7 इज आल्सो नॉट देन द 8 8 इज अ कॉमन एलिमेंट 9 इज अ कॉमन एलिमेंट 10 इज अ कॉमन एलिमेंट देयरफॉर द ए complement intersection b complement and that's contain the 8 9 10 now these two are the equal and hence from 1 and 2 a intersection b complement is equals to a complement intersection b complement okay now we'll take the next example next is a intersection b complement is equals to a complement union b complement now see this again x a b a union b okay A intersection B is a 1, 2, 5. A intersection B is a complement. Therefore, other than 1, 2, 5, which are in X? 1, 2, 5 nahi ghenar fakte yachyatla 1, 2, 5. Then we will take the all the elements. They are the 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the third one. A intersection B complement. What about the next side? That is A complement union B complement. This is the A and the B. They are the union. The 3, 4, okay, 6, 7. We will take the 8, 9, 10. They are the repeated. That's why we will take the single time. That is 8, 9, 10. Therefore, the A complement union B complement is equals to 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And hence, 3 and 4, these are the equal. Therefore, the A intersection B complement is equals to A complement union B complement. Okay. Now, the next example number 6. If P is equals to X is such that X square plus 14X plus 40 is equals to 0. Q is equals to, in curly bracket, X is such that X square minus 5X plus 6 is equals to 0. R is equals to, in curly bracket, X is such that X square plus 17X minus 60 is equals to 0. And the universal set capital X is equals to minus 20 minus 10. Okay, minus 4, 2, 3, 4. Then the find P union Q, P Q intersection R, third P union in bracket Q intersection R, fourth one P intersection in bracket Q union R. Okay, now first we factorize here. A quadratic equation is x square plus 14x plus 40. If you simplify this equation, then you will get x is equals to the solution set is a minus 10 and the 4. Similarly, this is also quadratic equation. The factors are similarly for the Q, x is such that x square minus 5x plus 6 is equals to 0. H factors are killed. Then you will get the numbers are 3 and 2. The factors are minus 3, minus 2, then you will get x is equals to 3, x is equals to 2. Okay. And for the capital R, x is such that x square plus 17x minus 60 is equals to 0. And again, the factors are x in bracket 20, in second bracket x minus 3. If you simplify it, then you will get x is equals to minus 20, x is equals to 3. A normal quadratic equation is normal. Simplify karayse. You will get the solution set minus 20 and the 3. Now, the what are the elements? The first P madhe kon konte minus 10 and 4. Q is a 3, 2 and R is a minus 20, 3. What about the X? Minus 20, minus 10, minus 4, 2, 3, 4 in this way. Okay. Now, the first is P is minus 10 and 4 and Q 3, 2 and their union. Normal question hai toh. Minus 10, minus 4, 3, 2. This is the Q, which is the elements are 3, 2. R is a minus 23. And what about the Q intersection R? The common element is 3. Now the next is a P, minus 10, minus 4, Q, 3, 2, R, minus 23. What about their intersection? The common element between the Q and the R, that is a 3. Okay. Now the P union with the Q intersection R. What is the P? P madhe konte kete minus 10 and minus 4. That's a union konashi karayche Q intersection R. union with the 3, and therefore you will get minus 10, minus 4 and the 3. Okay. Now the next, we have the P is the minus 10, minus 4 cube, 3 to R, minus 23. What about the P intersection Q union R? Okay. P intersection Q union R. Q आणि R चा union जर आपण इथे केला, then you will get the minus 23 and the 2. And what about their common? There is no common element between these two. And hence, P intersection Q union R, that's equals to 1. Okay. I can write here Q union R. Q union R, that is in bracket. What is the first minus 20 and the common elements are the 2 and 3. And what about the P here? P is equals to in curly bracket minus 10 minus 4. Okay. Ya doghanmadhye aplyala kay intersection. Is there any common element? No. Therefore it is a 5. Next question number 7. This is an easy question. If A and B are the subsets of X and N of X is equals to 50, N of A is 35, N of B is a 22. Fine. Also, that is a N of A complement intersection B complement is equals to 3. This is given. Then find N of A union B. Second, N of A intersection B. Third, N of A complement intersection B. Fourth, N of A complement union B complement. Now the first is N of A union B, that is equals to N of X minus N of A union B complement. Okay, now see this here, N of X is 50. And if you apply the complement sign here, then here you will get N of A complement intersection B. The complements are up and apply here. Then this union will become complement and ya doganna complement sign milte ithe. Therefore, the N of X is 50. N of A complement intersection B complement, we have given it, and that is a 3. 50 minus 3, that is equals to 47. This is the first one. What about the second? N of A intersection B is equals to, so sums of formula normal, is equals to N of A plus N of B minus their union. What about the N of A? N of A is a 35, N of B is a 22, minus their union, which is the 47. Just we have calculated here. That is a 35 plus 22 minus 47, that's equals to 10. Okay. Next, half formula important. N of A complement intersection B, and that's equals to N of B minus their intersection, A intersection B. What about the N of B? This is a 22. N of A intersection B is a 10. 22 minus 10, then you will get 12. This is the N of A complement intersection B. Now the next, N of A union B complement. N of A union B complement means what? N of X minus N of, again I will repeat this formula. It's N of A union B complement is equals to N of X minus N of A complement intersection B. But we know the value of N of A complement intersection B. That is that where N of X is already 50. And therefore, N of A union B complement, that is equals to 38. Now the next question. In a board examination, 40 students failed in physics, 40 in chemistry, 35 in mathematics, 20 failed in both physics and maths, okay, in mathematics and physics, 17 in physics and chemistry, 15 in mathematics and chemistry, and 5 in all the three subjects. If 350 students appeared for the examination, how many of them did not fail in any of three subjects? Okay. Now, the first we write here. P, the set of students failed in physics. C, the set of students failed in chemistry. M, the set of students failed in mathematics. Okay. And the, now first the, we'll draw the Venn diagram. The number of the student who failed in all three subjects, that is a mathematics, physics and chemistry. They are the 5. I will write here 5. Now the next here we said P first, second M, and here is a C. X is there, the universal set. Now the next, the number of the student who failed in both physics and maths. Okay, physics and maths, there are the 20 student. Okay, ithe kithe hote number of the student who failed in both examination physics and maths, they are the 20. Manje ithe doni milun kithe 20 paije, pan already ithe 15 zalele, therefore here the number of the students are 15 only. Next, the number of the student failed in maths and chemistry. Maths and chemistry, they are the 15. Ma 15 ait, ma already ithe kay zale, ta 5 zalele, then here you will get 10. Okay, now the next, the number of the student failed in physics and the chemistry. Okay, physics and chemistry, they are the 17. Okay, ithe 5 zalele, then total kithe paije, ta 17, then here 17 minus 5, you will get here 12. Okay, now next, the number of the student who failed in physics, take it at 48. Mo 40 madna kay kay minus karna, ta 40 madna 15 plus 5 20, 20 plus 12, then you will get 32. 40 minus 32, here you will get 8. Next, what about the mathematics? The total number of the student failed in mathematics is 35. Okay, maya M madhe ta aplyala 35 lihayche astil, then what about here, 15 plus 5 is a 20, 20 plus 10 30, 35 minus 30 manje ithe kithe yenar fakta 5. There are the 5 students who failed in only mathematics, 8 students who failed in only physics. Okay, next, what about the chemistry? Ata chemistry che baptit total fail kithe tar 40 hai. Okay, mag yanchi total 40 paije aplyala aleli, then here you have 5 plus 10 15, 15 plus 12, then you will get the 27, then the total is 40, 40 minus 27, then here you will get the 30 student, and in this way the Venn diagram is completed here. The number of the student who failed in at least one subject, that is a N of M union P union C, then you will have N of M union P union C is equals to N of M plus N of P plus N of C plus their intersection minus N of M intersection P minus N of P intersection C minus N of M intersection C. First is 35, 40, 40, and the next is 5, minus 20, minus 17. All these numbers we have given here, minus 17, minus 15. Okay, and if we calculate, then the number of the student who failed in at least one subject is 68. It's 68 subject madhe minimum ekatari subject madhe ya madhe students kashe tarte fail hai. Now the next, the number of the student who did not fail in any examination means they pass, that is the 350 total number of the student minus 68, and they are the 282. Okay, means what, there are the 68 student ashe hote ki te at least ekatari subject madhe fail ho, but totally or in all subjects the past students are 282. Therefore the number of the student who did not fail in any subject is 282. Okay, easy question hai toh Venn diagram, yes, type check questions exercise madhe dekhla hai. A company produces, next question, the company produces 3 kinds of products A, B and C. The company studied the preference of 1600 consumers and found that the product A was liked by 1250, the product B was liked by 930, and the product C was liked by 1000. The products A and B were liked by 650. The products B and C were liked by 610, and the products C and A were liked by 700 consumers. Okay, 30 consumers did not take any of these three products. Find the number of consumers who liked all the three products. Only two of these products. Okay, now see this here. That is a given. The totally 1600 consumers were studied. Therefore, the n of x is equals to 1600. Let A be the set of all the consumers who liked the product A. B is the set of all consumers who liked the product B. C is the set of all consumers who liked the product C. Therefore, n of A, first of all, n of A is equals to 1250, n of B is a 930, n of C is a 1000. The first who like the A and B is 650, B and C is 610, A and C is a 700, and the number of the consumer who do not like all the three products, that is n of A complement intersection, B complement intersection, C complement, and that's equals to 30. Okay, and this is the Venn diagram. Now first we will see this here. This is one more again important formula. N of A union B union C is equals to N of X minus N of A union B union C, and it's a complement. If we take their complement, N of A union B union C, a complement ka honar ya complement mule ya union cha intersection honar ya union cha intersection ani tigana complement milnar. Means what? N of A union B union C is equals to N of X minus N of A complement intersection N of B complement intersection N of C complement. Munun problem saglyat important tumhala samajna hi far important hai. That is, there are the 30 consumers who do not like all the three products. Means what? N of A complement intersection B complement intersection C complement. That is equals to 30. Yavarna apan kay find out karu shakto ki आपण असे कंझ्युमर्स बघणार की ऍटलीस्ट एक तरी त्यांना तो आवडला पाहिजे. मीन्स व्हॉट? एन ऑफ ए युनियन बी युनियन सी इज इक्वल्स टू एन ऑफ एक्स मायनस एन ऑफ ए युनियन बी युनियन सी अँड देअर कॉम्प्लिमेंट. या कॉम्प्लिमेंट जर इथे अप्लाय केला, दिस युनियन विल बिकम इंटरसेक्शन अँड प्रत्येक एलिमेंट हा त्याचा कॉम्प्लिमेंट होणार. मीन्स व्हॉट? एन ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू दी ऑल द थ्री डू नॉट लाईक. Means what? They are the 30%, and therefore N of A union B union C is equals to 1570. Manje kamit kami ek ter product avadnari loko kiti yata 1570. Okay, therefore the N of A union B union C is equals to 1570. Now all the three products, okay, all the three products means what? That is we must find out here. Now see this here. All the three products, that's why here we must use the formula. N of A union B union C is equals to N of A plus N of B plus N of C minus N of A intersection B minus N of B intersection C minus N of C intersection A plus N of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, now all the three at least like the number of the consumers are 1570. N of A, we have the N of A is equals to 1250. Next, N of B is a 930. N of C is a 1000. And what about the N of A intersection B is a 650. N of B intersection C is a 610. N of A intersection C is a 700 plus N of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, now we will simplify here. What is that? N of A intersection B intersection C is equals to 1570, and if we simplify this, then if we add all these three, then here you will get 1960, and if we add all these three, then here you will get 3180. Okay. We want to calculate the number N of A intersection B intersection C, and that's equals to 1570 plus 1960 and minus 3180, and then you will get the number of the consumer who liked all the three products, and that is equals to 350. Okay, only two of these products means what? N of A intersection B intersection C complement, and this equals to, this is again very important formula, N of A intersection B minus N of A intersection B intersection C by using this formula. Okay, yeah, formula no, sir. N of A intersection B complement manje kay? K N of A minus their A intersection B. Similar here, N of A intersection B intersection C complement, and that's nothing but the N of A intersection B minus N of A intersection B intersection C. That is A intersection B is a 650. Okay. And minus there A intersection B intersection C, that is a 350. And if we subtract it, then you will get N of A intersection B intersection C complement. Means what? They like A and B, they do not like C. Similarly, we can find out the consumer who like B and C and not A. By using this formula, N of A complement intersection B intersection C is equals to N of B intersection C minus N of A intersection B intersection C. Okay. What about the B intersection C? B intersection C is a 610 minus all the three intersections, means what? A intersection B intersection C, that is equals to again the 350. Then you will get the number of the consumer who like B and C but not A is a 260. Now the next, N of A intersection B complement intersection C, means here they like A and C but do not like B, that is equals to N of C intersection A minus N of A intersection B intersection C, that is a, again it's a 350. C intersection A, that is equals to 700. A intersection C is a 700, and hence you will get the number of the consumer who like A and C but not B is a 350, and therefore all the three, we can add all these three, 260, 350 and here 300. Therefore the number of the consumer who liked only two of these three products are N of A intersection B intersection C complement plus N of A intersection B complement intersection C plus N of A complement intersection B intersection C, and that's equals to 300 plus 350 plus 260, and then you will get 910. Okay, in this way. Therefore, the number of the consumer who like only two of the three products is 910. Okay. Now you can see this. Don formula yamadhe sagalyat important hai. Assam cha. Okay. And the two of these. This is the important formula. Okay. Now the next concept, maximum and the minimum of sets. Now here there are the some important formulas for the minimum and the maximum of a set. Okay, first the minimum of their union and maximum of their union. How to find out? That the minimum of N of A union B is equals to maximum of N of A plus N of B. Sorry, maximum of N of A and N of B. What about the maximum of N of A union B? And that's nothing but the sum of N of A plus N of B. Now see this. First, again, I will repeat here. Minimum of N of A union B means what? Maximum. Ya dogatla maximum ghena. Whatever that. That is nothing but the minimum of A union, N of A union B. And what about their maximum? Maximum of N of A union B is a sum of N of A plus N of B. This is the first one. It is for only the union. Okay, this is for the union. Okay. What about their intersection? Again, the minimum of N of A intersection B, that's 0. And maximum of N of A intersection B is the minimum of N of A, N of B, and this is for the section. You must remember this. This is for the union. Union sathi hai minimum and maximum hai. And here minimum and maximum for the intersection. Now we'll see the one more example. N of A is 10, N of B is 20. Then the minimum of N of A union B is equals to, what is the formula for the union? Minimum of N of A union B is equals to maximum of N of A, N of B. That is a maximum of N of A union, maximum of N of A comma N of B. Which is the maximum here? The maximum is 20. And hence, the minimum of N of A union B is equals to maximum of, by using the first formula, that is a 10 and 20. And which is the maximum? 20 is maximum. Next, this is the minimum. What about the maximum of N of A union B? Maximum of N of A union B is equals to N of A plus N of B. And that is equals to 10 plus 20 is equals to 30. And hence, N of A union B lies between, this is the minimum one and this is the maximum one. Also, minimum of their intersection is 0. And the maximum is minimum of N of A and N of B or N of B. Okay. Now first there the minimum of A intersection B is a 0. No problem. Maximum of N of A intersection B is a minimum of their A and B, A or B. That is a 10 and 20, which is a 10. And hence the intersection of N of A intersection B lies between 0 and the 10. Okay. Now we'll see the one more example. In a survey of 100 consumers, 72 likes the product A, 45 like the product B. Find least and the most number that must have liked both the product A and B. Okay, least and the most they like means we want to find out their union. Let N of A and N of B be the number of consumers who like the product A and B respectively. N of A is 72, N of B is 45. Their union, if we simplify this, that is N of here, A union B is equals to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. Therefore, N of A here, A union B is equals to 72 plus 45 minus their intersection. If you add this, then you will get 170 minus their intersection. Okay. But as only the 100 consumers are surveyed there, therefore 117 minus N of A intersection B, that's less than 100. Okay. And that's why therefore the 117 minus 100 is less than or equals to N of A intersection B. We can easily simplify this. Or subtract on both sides by 100, add on both sides by N of A intersection B, then you will get this. 117 minus 100, then you will get the 17. And hence, the 17 is less than N of A intersection B. So the least number of the consumer who like both the products is a 17. Okay. Next, N of A intersection B is less than N of A. N of A intersection B is less than N of B. Therefore, N of A intersection B is a minimum of N of A or the N of B. That is 72 or 45. And that is nothing but which is the minimum? 45 is the minimum. So, the most number of the consumer who like the both the products is 45. Okay, and in this way you can find out the least and the most number that must like both the products A and B. Least are 17 and the most are 45. That is a least means what? Minimum, the number of the consumer who like the both the products is 17 and most they are the 45. Now in this way I had completed all the basic concept, all the solved examples before the exercise 5.1. And in this way, I am completing this video. In my next video, I will explain the exercise 5.1. Now we'll see in the next video. Till then, goodbye.